Hello, creators. I was pleasantly surprised this morning to see an email from Skylum with the latest update, 1.0.7. It's a small update, but we're going to take a look at it. So the first thing we're going to look at is the addition of favorites. And the way it works is, let's say I want to create a favorite for develop, which is what I use first most of the time. You just have to hover over it, right click, and now you'll see add to favorites, and it'll create this section here under favorites. I can do the same thing for any of these other options. I'm gonna create a favorite for Relight AI, which is something I use quite a bit. And if I were to go into these, it works the same way. It just now has this purplish hue to it, but all the functionality remains the same. Pretty easy, pretty straightforward. The next update is the ability to do masks in layers. In the previous 1.0.6 update, you weren't able to do it in layers, and now you can. So if I were to bring in another image here, I'm going to bring in this moon, for example. You see now that it has the masking option, and I can also go to all the other tools where the mask is available. Now, with that being said, I did find something a little curious. I'm not sure if it was done by design. So first, what I'm going to do for this image is convert to black and white, and I'm going to import the same image in and bring the opacity all the way up. We're going to click on mask. As you see, there's the masking option in layers properties. We're going to trigger the mask AI, and then we're going to click on transport. But you see what happens? It automatically removes the background. So if I grab the top layer here, you're going to see that it's transparent now, other than these areas which require some cleanup. I'm not sure if this was done by design. I think it's kind of like a sneak peek to the background removal function, but I'm not sure if I want this to happen by default. So if I go back into the mask AI here, if I click on the sky, for example, and stack the mask selections, I can easily take out the masks now, and you see that just the bike and the sky's in color. I think it's handy because it makes it fairly quick to do. So let me show you another example. So I'll just use this image here and show you how it works for portraits. And again, for portraits, I think this is very handy. So if we bring the opacity up, we go under masking, and this time we're going to click on human. And as you see, the background has been removed automatically. So I actually quite like that. I was quite surprised that it worked that way. And of course, we could paint back or restore the areas that you want in color. But again, I'm not sure if this was done by design, but definitely a pleasant surprise. Of course, there were more bug fixes done again with this update, which I'll leave a link in the description below where you can find all the details on Skylum's website. In the meantime, if you are new to photo editing and you know nothing about the histogram, make sure to check out this video coming up, which will explain how to read the histogram and how to use it to edit your photos. Until the next video, my friends, I'll see you when I see you.